JRA 501. What is the Nuclear Regulatory Commission? It is an independent agency of the United States government that was established by the Energy Reorganization Act of 1974. It began operations in 1975 as one of two successor agencies to the United States Atomic Energy Commission. The NRC was charged with overseeing reactor safety and security, reactor licensing and renewal, radioactive material safety, and spent fuel management, storage, security, recycling, and disposal. Some observers have criticized the commission as an example of regulatory capture, and the NRC has been accused of doing an inadequate job by the Union of Concerned Scientists. New inquiry at San Onofre focuses on the Nuclear Regulatory Commission. This is a photograph of Allison Macfarlane. She is the chair of the Nuclear Regulatory Commission, or the No Regulatory Commission. Yet another investigation has been launched into the outage at the San Onofre Nuclear Generating Station. This time, it's about the conduct of the No Regulatory Commission. Joseph A. McMillan, Assistant Inspector General for Investigations at the NRC's Office of the Inspector General, confirmed the probe on Monday. The Inspector General performs investigations to prevent and detect fraud, waste, abuse, and mismanagement, with its authority extending to possible criminal statutes and misconduct by employees. Separately, the Nuclear Commission Office of Investigations has been looking into whether Edison provided complete and accurate information to the agency regarding steam generator problems that have sidelined San Onofre's two reactors since January 2012. Nuclear Commission Chairman Allison Macfarlane offered a brief description of the investigations in response to concerns raised by Senator Barbara Boxer, chairman of the Senate's Environment and Public Works Committee, about the safety of a San Onofre restart proposal. Each of these ongoing investigations focuses on allegations of willful wrongdoing, Macfarlane wrote in a letter. While these investigations are not focused on technical safety issues concerning the steam generators at San Onofre in San Clemente, California, let me be clear that any information that appears to have the potential to impact public health and safety will be immediately provided by the investigators to the NRC staff. McMillan of the Investigator General's Office declined to provide additional details. The office's audits and probes can be designed simply to promote economy, efficiency, and effectiveness of programs and operations, but a main focus is investigation of alleged staff misconduct that could adversely affect matters related to health and safety. Inspector General investigations can be initiated or referred by almost anyone. Private citizens, nuclear plant employees, nuclear commission employees, Congress, or other federal, state, or local law enforcement agencies, according to the office's website. So, unfortunately, private citizens, watchdog committees, nuclear plant employees have contacted the NRC and have asked for investigations. For some reason, that has fallen pretty much on deaf ears until Senator Barbara Boxer spoke up. And I just want to say thank you to all of the concerned citizens and all of the people who have dedicated so much time and energy into investigating this for themselves and actually doing the NRC's job. Ace Hoffman, Daniel Hirsch, I mean, the list goes on and on and on. There are many, many people who have been professionals, experts, who have given all of their hard work on a silver platter to the NRC so that the NRC could do an investigation without really having to do anything. So thank you to everyone. Plant operator Southern California Edison made it clear it is aware of the probe last week in disclosures to investors filed with the Securities and Exchange Commission. Edison is seeking to restart one San Onofre reactor at partial power for a limited period as it looks for a long-term solution to rapid wear on steam generator tubes carrying radioactive water. So yes, they want to fire up a crippled, unsafe reactor at partial power and then take a look at the long-term solution, risking 8 million people's lives. Not only that, but their evacuation plan does not reach far enough and is so outdated that it doesn't even include a plan that would be effective for the people within a 10-mile, a 12-mile radius, let alone 8 million people. Senator Boxer, God bless you, has raised concerns that Edison may have short-circuited an adequate safety review of replacement steam generators that were installed beginning in 2009 and is urging the Nuclear Commission to complete investigations into that review before authorizing a restart of the plant. A report released in March by generator manufacturer Mitsubishi Heavy Industries showed that it and Edison grew concerned while designing the generators about forces of steam flows on generator tubing, but discarded some remedies as ineffectual and because they might trigger a reassessment of the plant's overall safety. So they were a little concerned, but not concerned enough to actually worry about the citizens nor the plant workers, or the only thing they were really concerned about was if this went wrong, which it did, that they were going to lose some money. They don't care about the people. After all, their motto is profits before people. State utility regulators, meanwhile, have opened an investigation to determine what costs from the idled plant can reasonably be passed on to utility customers across much of Southern California. So as if over $1 billion isn't enough that the ratepayers have already paid in the last year, as if that's not enough, now the California Public Utility Commission is going to figure out now what other costs can be passed on to the ratepayers for a nuclear power plant that is not even operational. But this doesn't surprise me because Michael Peavy of the CPUC used to work for Southern California Edison. Where? Yes, at San Onofre. So just business as usual. But at least there is an investigation going on. And maybe if you would like to assist Mr. McMillan in his investigation of the no regulatory commissions conduct, please feel free to, I should have looked him up, but please feel free to help him out and send him whatever information that you have. I think that would behoove us. As always, God bless.